I grew up having everything that I need was my worst nightmare. He told me that he loved me.
Until the tragic day.
Tell me about your life.
I was 13 when my worst nightmare took place. I never imagined that I would ever be alone in my life, but God ordered her plans.
My parents died in a car crash. Left to roam the streets of the city alone without any means. I did not have any relatives who could take me in, and my parents did not exactly leave me with a fortune that I could sustain myself.
We were not rich, but we were happy until the tragic day.
It's exceptionally hard to live each day without a roof on my head. And it was worse when I would wake up and realize that I really have nothing left. But I just could not help but hold on to the little hope that I have left in me. Even though I was alone, I knew that there were lots of chances out there by which I could improve my life. Realization kept in mind. I knew for a fact that one day I would be standing on top of one of those highest buildings and I would be the engineer behind it. A few months after, a woman saw me sitting at the sidewalk, and she talked to me. I was shocked at why she would actually talk to a dirty kid like me. But I also learned that she had a big heart. She and her husband adopted me, and for which I would always be thankful. They helped me achieve my biggest dream. I dedicated myself to my studies because I knew for that fact it was the only way that I could ever repay them.
Now, I'm one of the most sought-after engineers in the whole country. And now I'm not alone anymore.
I am engaged to this wonderful woman.
Who were you back then?
Back in the days, I was a party girl. It was my way of escaping the harsh reality.
I might be anyone, a lone fool out in the sun. Your heartbeat of solid gold. I love you, you'll never know. When the daylight comes, you feel so cold. You know I'm too afraid of my heart to let you go. When it burns fire, we'll be right back.
I won't make it to the show without you.
When we checked out of life, I was living for the both of us.
Ha! No! You did it for you!
Look, this is about Kate, and I'm sorry. Can we finally move on?
It's not about Kate, Tom!
Really? Because I'm pretty sure that this is what we've been yelling about for the past hour!
Do you even hear anything I say to you? Do you even see me every day? Tom, I wake up every day and I don't feel like a woman at all. I'm empty and this space can never be filled anymore.
One morning, I was having one of my nightmares again. A nightmare that was a vivid picture in the past. Weeks passed by and I never saw him again. I tried to look for him because I desperately needed to talk to him. But when I did see him again, my heart shattered into a million pieces. was depressed. I was only 16. I did not know what to do, but I knew for a fact that I had to take care of the baby. I would not walk out on him like what my mother did to me when she was not strong enough to face reality of her and my dad's marriage breaking. I had to be strong for my child. I may have had a hard life. My mother left me, the guy who I thought loved me, walked out on me and my baby. But I would never walk out on my responsibility, and I am happy. And now, I am a home-based chef, and I am happy. We had a small family, and we were happy. We did not have much, but we were contented. But happiness is not a constant thing in life, and when the storm in my life began, it left me with nothing but pain and anger.
Trabaho mo. Okay ka lang?
Oo nga pala, kalimutan ko sabihin sa iyo.
Ano?
Nawalan ako ng trabaho.
Ano? Nawalan ka ng trabaho?
Ang gagawin natin, dami pa natin utang. Hindi pa na natin mababayaran.
Ano ba nangyari? Hindi mo alam, tapos tinanggal ka, tapos hindi mo alam.
May solusyon sa problema natin, Pam.
Kain ka lang yun.
Gusto naman pag-aaral ko.
Okay lang po.
Nakuha ko pala yung
card mo, anak.
Teka. Anong hindi sinabi?
Ikot!
Hindi ako makakalpa patungpato ng aking problema. Ngunit ito ang ipagpapalit mo.
Tama na!
Saan ka galing?
Pakialam mo.
Ba't ngayon ka lang?
Ay, sa tingin mo.
Kanina pa ako naghihintay sa'yo.
Eh, ba't mo naman ako inihintay?
Ikaw na nga yung walang trabaho, umiinom ka ba?
Sino ba namang hindi umiinom? Ang dami-dami kong problema. Kailangan ko makalimutan yun para hindi na ako magproblema bukas.
Kasalanan ko ba yun?
Eh ano sinasabi mo? Kasalanan ko ba? Kasalanan ko ba?
Ano ka ba? Ba't ka ganyan? Ba't ka ganyan?
Wala akong pakialam.
Wala akong kialam? Paano na ako? Si Jan! Sumi! Wala ka na rin ba ang pakialam sa amin? Subukan mo! Subukan mo lang! Pagod na kami sa'yo!
One day, something I never thought would happen took place.
For the first time, I was scared of my own father. It was my worst nightmare.
Thank you.
I struggled to survive each day, but I did. I became a working student, and soon enough, I found myself as a scholar in a law school. I won many cases regarding family violence, and now
I'm one of the best lawyers in the field. With the given events that happened in your past, how did you feel right now?
I am happy, and I am contented with my life.
Tell me something about yourself.
I grew up having everything that I needed and wanted in life. People would say that I was lucky, but little did they know that behind the luxury, I was broken inside. The truth is, I was living with my stepfather.
People see my smiles, but they don't see the sadness in my eyes. Yes, I was well provided, but I never felt loved. My so-called parents never noticed me, and my step-siblings loathed me and always bullied me. I always prayed to God that someday I would have a happy and supportive family.
And now, I cannot be any happier.
And God listened to me. Now, I am married to the man of my dreams.
But before that, may I ask what is your opinion about family planning?